Hi, I'm Evgeny, a PhD student of the Liège University, and this is an extended version of the PICO talk I have presented on 28th of April. The work I'm presenting here was funded by the Belgian Science Policy, BELSPO, and supported by the Liège University. The work I present here is a part of Face It project. This project targeted functional biodiversity of human-affected ecosystems like those that are exposed to dredging, trawling, and that are associated with foundation structures of the offshore wind farms. My work is about the latter. On the left-hand side, you see how filter feeders, such as the blue mussel, colonize offshore wind farm turbine foundations, then filter mineral and organic particles from water, lump them together, and excrete as speckled pellets that rapidly sink to the bottom. Because these pellets are rich in carbon, they perturb the sediment biogeochemical cycles. However, the long-term consequences and the spatial extent of this biodeposition is barely known. My task was to parameterize this biodeposition from a single turbine foundation and then upscale it over a wind farm and over the southern bight of the North Sea, as you see on the center and right. During the project meeting with the stakeholders, we were also asked to target several policy-driving questions concerning a new offshore wind farm that will be operational by 2026, that you see in red on the right-hand side. The perimeter of this wind farm was drawn by the authorities over a natural reserve Natura 2000 that you see on the left, and its protected gravel beds that are biodiversity hotspots. The biodeposition of the new offshore wind farm might affect the gravel beds ecosystems. So, the essence of the policy-driven questions are: what would be the effect of the new offshore wind farm on carbon deposition over the protected gravel beds, and how can we minimize it? The modeling system that was chosen for the study is a coupled model COAST, a Rutgers University branch. It comprises the hydrodynamic model ROMS, wave model SWALM, and sediment model CSTMS. The atmospheric model WRF was replaced by bulk fluxes calculation using data from ESMWF. At the open boundaries, the model was forced by Copernicus Marine Service model outputs. Tides were modulated using a regional product from TPXO. Waves were modulated from the global product of the wave watch model. Sediment model was initialized with grain sizes and porosity from regional maps and Flanders Marine Institute data. The model was meticulously parameterized for all the main state variables and certain processes like discharges, through the straits, and tidal dynamics of resuspension. We have also implemented a filtration model, and I will talk about it slightly later. The model has two model grids: the coarse grid covering the southern bight of the North Sea on the left-hand side, and high-resolution model grid covering primarily the Belgian economic zone on the right-hand side. The models are embedded one into another interactively, or by other words, in two-way nesting. We analyze the results from the high-resolution model, because the coarse resolution model serves primarily to smooth the boundary conditions. Our implemented filtration model is a modified version of the filtration model from Slavic 2019. The differences between the two is that our model is not a part of the biological model and accounts for inorganic particles. Instead, we shortcutted the food chain, and fast and slow carbon are represented as sediment particles. The mussels living in the upper 6 meters of the turbine foundation filter water column and produce speckled pellets as a function of available carbon, lumping together inorganic and organic particles. The pellets are quickly deposited and immediately degrade back to their primary compartments. All the considered particles are subject to the processes that you see on the screen. On the left-hand side, you see again the new concession area, or the NCA. To respond to the stakeholders' questions, We have developed two types of scenarios for the NCA. The first type differs in placement. The northern placement scenarios that you see in the upper right corner are designed to allocate turbines as far as possible from the gravel beds. The southern placement that you see in the lower right corner allocates turbines as closest to the Belgian coast as possible, completely ignoring gravel beds. Another type of scenarios differs in number of turbines, because the total amount of energy that will be delivered by the NCA is known. We composed three scenarios with installed nameplate capacity of 8, 10 and 13 megawatts per turbine, resulting in 250, 210 and 162 turbines in the NCA correspondingly. We also have run a so-called reference scenario without any turbines to estimate a top flux before any human involvement. On the screen, you see the change in top flux for the northern scenario with 250 turbines compared to the reference scenario. The top flux increases up to 50% inside OVF perimeters, offshore wind farms perimeters. The increase also propagates outside of the offshore wind farms perimeters, following residual currents and aligned with the direction of regional tidal ellipses. Further away, 5 km away from the offshore wind farm perimeters, the deposition top flux decreases by several percent. If we compare the northern on the left-hand side and the southern placement on the right-hand side, we will see that the gravel beds, that are transparent polygons here, will be severely affected by the top deposition flux in case of the southern placement, while in case of the northern placement, the increase is rather moderate. To further quantify it, we have calculated the yearly spatially averaged top flux on the gravel beds to each of the scenarios, and the results are presented on the bar plot on the left-hand side, where R0 stands for the reference scenario without any wind farm. And then there are three scenarios for northern and three scenarios for the southern placement. In case of the southern placement, the top flux over the pink gravel beds on the picture on the right-hand side will increase by more than 50% compared to the reference scenarios, while in case of the northern placement, this increase will not exceed 10%. The gravel beds outside of the NCA in cyan color will not be affected. The number of turbines play a marginal role in top flux alteration. As a conclusion, the offshore wind farms alter top deposition flux with a high increase in the close proximity up to 5 km and decrease further away. For the new concession area, the priority should be given to the northern placement scenarios. The placement is much more important than the number of turbines. Here you see people of our working group MAST, that stands for Modeling for Aquatic Ecosystems, and is a part of the Liège University. We thank you for your attention.